Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. We are back with a new video. If you like our content, please like the video and do share it. So let us start with the first news. Recently, the Indian Oil Corporation has sought approval from the Directorate General of Quality Assurance of the Armed Forces to approve winter diesel. So what is this about? Winter diesel is a specialized fuel that was introduced by Indian Oil Corporation last year specifically for the high altitude regions where temperatures are very low, such as Ladakh region, where ordinary diesel can become unusable. The ordinary diesel becomes unusable because its flow characteristics change at temperature as low as minus 30 degrees Celsius. The viscosity of diesel increases at this temperature. And so, IOCL launched winter diesel, which contains additives to maintain lower viscosity in such kind of low temperatures. This winter diesel also causes less pollution because before the launch of it, the consumers in areas such as low temperature would mix kerosene with diesel to make it usable, and kerosene causes more air pollution. So, as soon as the Directorate General of Quality Assurance approves the IOCL's demand to produce winter diesel, the armed forces would be using winter diesel in areas like Ladakh. Due to the spread of coronavirus in the whole world, the places of public gathering are closed in India, like schools, colleges, shopping places, and even the Parliament of India. The monsoon session of the Parliament, according to a normal year, begins in mid-July, but due to the pandemic, we do not know when the Parliament will resume its work. Earlier, when the virus arrived, the budget session of the Parliament ended abruptly on March 23, which was 11 days ahead of its schedule. And according to the Constitution of India, there should not be a gap of more than 6 months between two Parliament sessions, which means that the next Parliament session can be started on September 23 if the Parliament session is not resumed in the mid-July. Recently, a senior Biju Janata Dal MP and chairman of the Standing Committee on Labour, Bhartruhari Mahtab, has wrote a letter to the Speaker of Lok Sabha to conduct the proceedings of the Parliament and House panel meetings virtually. Also, the opposition has asked the government to stick to the calendar and hold the monsoon session as planned in the last week of July, as there are many issues pending before the government of India, like multiple issues on the pandemic, financial crisis, the confrontation with China in the Galwan Valley, and the issues related to economic reforms. The government is also looking towards an option of holding the sessions of Parliament virtually or in a hybrid way, where some lawmakers are physically present while others will join online. So, how will it be possible to conduct the virtual or a hybrid session in India? Did any country in the world conducted such virtual sessions of the Parliament? And will it be possible for India to do so? So let us look at the challenges behind it. Many countries in the world have conducted their parliament session and panel meetings virtually, like Germany, USA, France, Australia, Argentina, Brazil, Denmark, etc. Also, UK's House of Commons was conducted by a hybrid proceedings in which Zoom was used. So, it can be possible for India to conduct virtual or hybrid sessions, but with some challenges. The first question will be about the quorum itself. Will it be enough if 1/10 of the members log in virtually to attend the proceedings? And are all members tech-savvy to effectively participate in a virtual session? The second comes speakers' concerns. In an e-parliament, the speaker will have a tough job keeping an eye on all the members to ascertain who wants to intervene or who wants to speak. Will the speaker would need to scan multiple screens for that at a time, or will the assistance of any staff would be required for that? Another big challenge in India conducting the parliament session would be translating the proceedings in real time for everyone who is connected online, because in physical parliament the proceedings are translated in different regional languages as well as Hindi and English. And if the parliament moves on to conducting any parliament business like passing any bill, then how it will be possible to conduct voting online? The virtual parliament will also fundamentally change how the opposition opposes in the house. The opposition MPs will not be able to adjourn the house forcibly or cause any disruption by holding any placards like in the physical parliament or staging any walkout. So the opposition need to depend on effective debates to put their point across. This thing needs to be thought thoroughly, and if the virtual parliament becomes new reality, then it will give a signal for the state assemblies and councils across the whole country. The Food and Agriculture Organization has warned India to remain on high alert against the locust attack for the next 4 weeks. The FAO has analyzed that the locust swarms which have migrated to the Indian-Pakistan border recently will be expected to return back to Rajasthan in the start of monsoon in coming days. These swarms will return to Rajasthan to join other swarms which will be arriving from Iran and Pakistan, and also the swarms which are arriving from the Horn of Africa in mid-July. The FAO has also said that early breeding along the Indian-Pakistan border has already occurred, and more number of locust swarm would be arriving by mid-August. The countries which have been warned to remain on high alert are India, Pakistan, Sudan, Ethiopia, South Sudan, and Somalia. Now, let us get into the basics of it. What is a locust? The locust is similar to a grasshopper or cricket pest which we have seen, but it is a special kind of grasshopper because they can stay in two forms. One is solitary form and the other is gregarious form. When they are alone, they stay in solitary forms, looking green. But when they are in groups, they are in gregarious forms. And this gregarious form will form the locust swarms. And for the locust swarm to grow, the environmental conditions which are favorable to them will be lot of rainfall and moisturized land. The locusts are migratory pests and they travel in swarms which are very big. There can be about 10 million to 20 million locusts in 1 square kilometer of area in a swarm. When these locust swarms are arriving, they damage crops, trees, barks and grass. They eat everything that comes in their way. An average locust eats about 2 grams of crop, and so around an average locust swarm can consume about the food of 2500 to 5000 people in a single day. Looking at the situation in India, Rajasthan is the most affected state in the country by the locust swarms, and the other states which are affected are Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Haryana and Bihar. So, how can these locust swarms be controlled from damaging the crops? Normally, the insecticides or pesticides are sprayed over the locust swarms, and so they can be controlled from damaging the crops. India on 4th July also did the same by sending a Bell helicopter with the insecticides and sprayed it over the Jaisalmer district in over 25 places. Besides the helicopter spraying the insecticides, drones are also used by India to spray at locations which are inaccessible from the helicopter to spray. And India is the first country which is using drones for controlling the locust swarms. China has recently reported a case of a bubonic plague in Bayan Nur area, which is in North Inner Mongolian Autonomous Region. This region is between Mongolia and China. The spread of this bubonic plague was unclear, and so the authorities have asked the people to report if they found any sick or dead marmot. Marmot is a kind of large squirrel which is found in larger plains. Also, 5 days before, the Chinese news agency had reported that there are 2 suspected cases of bubonic plague in the Khwod province in western Mongolia, where 2 brothers have eaten the marmot meat. So, what is this bubonic plague? The bubonic plague is caused by the bacteria Yersinia pestis, which is usually found in small mammals and their fleas. And the disease usually spreads from bite of the fleas that have fed upon the infected creatures like mice, rats, rabbits, squirrels, etc. This bubonic plague is usually characterized by painful swollen lymph nodes, with its symptoms such as onset of fever, head and body aches, weakness, vomiting and nausea. This disease, bubonic plague, used to be fatal in the Middle Ages in Europe when there was no antibiotic or medicine for it. But during the recent times, the antibiotic of the bubonic plague is available, and so in the recent times, in today's time, the bubonic plague is not that fatal. This disease, bubonic plague, has been referred once as the Black Death of Europe during the 14th century, when it was one of the worst pandemics in human history, which have wiped half of the population of Europe continent. Moving on towards our last news. On Sunday, India overtook Russia to become the 3rd world's most affected country in the coronavirus pandemic. India in a single day reported a spike of 24,000 cases with 425 deaths. India now has total number of cases at 697,000, among which 2,53,000 are active cases. Talking about the worst most affected states in India, Maharashtra comes first with the total of 2,00,000 total cases and 86,000 active cases. Tamil Nadu comes second with 1,11,000 total cases and 46,000 active cases. And Delhi would be the 3rd worst affected state with 99,000 total cases and 25,000 active cases. So, this is it for today. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates from our channel.